perfection leaves you cold, when quality means anything but glossy images, when all else fails, it's time for Real George's Back Room. Tonight, witness DP and the Grays with their great new video, Bombs, from Music Express. Music also brings us Robyn Hitchcock with Raymond Chandler Evening. Con Demek is live at Noise Night 288. Firehose gives us Brave Captain from SST Records, and also from SST, it's Leading Trains and Das Damen. Mike Eck interviews them at QE2 in Albany. Grab a beverage, relax. It's time to give imperfection one more chance.
We'll be right back. bombs, do right. Bombs, show your power. Bombs, show your might. Here come. When's it gonna stop? Kill 10,000 people in one little time. Well, the USA all the way. But you got your hands dirty in a minute with. In the Bay of Pigs and Chipley too. And now you're messing around in El Salvador. Give him weapons to Israel. And it's gonna be true. Straight to hell. Superpower was the plan in Spain. We're talking about life. Ain't that insane? New York City, Boston, LA, talking about the bombs every day. Berlin, Paris, Amsterdam, Rome, hoping the bombs won't hit down. I'm Vietnam veteran, ain't it yet? You know I lived right through that mess. Now put down your take and listen to what I say. You know this could be your last day. Bombs to the left, me bombs to the right. Bombs show you how, bombs to the right. Hip hop, what you gonna drive? Kill 1,000 people in one little job.
It's a Raymond Chandler evening at the end of someone's day, and I'm standing in my pocket and I'm slowly turning gray. I remember what I told you, but I can't remember.
The sounds of America's ingenuity and backbone can be music to an industrialist ear. And if you find this pleasing, then you might like this. ...25-year-old Tom Rella of Albany and his musical sidekick, 22-year-old Damian Katera of Troy, make up Con Demek. That stands for Contemporary Demechanization, part of the wave of alternative music that some are calling industrial noise, but that Tom and Damian prefer to call the harsh atmospheric sound. They use a combination of instruments, synthesizers, and, well, junk to create that sound.
A textured assault on the senses, multi-textured assault, I would think, especially because of the volume level.
This song is called Disarm Your Mind. It's an example of the kind of music being featured each Sunday night at Albany's avant-garde Lark Street Night Spot, Club 288. It's definitely not for the faint of heart. Well, Con Demek may not be your musical cup of tea, but just think you'll be able to grow with this music at Club 288's Sunday night series of New Editions music. But I sort of feel sorry for the neighbors here. Ken Screvin, New Center 6 on Lark Street in Albany.
Let's go now! Hello?
Hello, everyone. My name is Mike Eck, bigger than ever. And tonight we're at QE2 in the dressing room with JP from The Plague and and Das Trains or The Leaving Damon. Actually, Das Damon. Damon. I'm sorry. And The Leaving Trons. Both bands on SST. You can go around and introduce yourself and which band you're from.
I am Sam. I'm in The Leaving Trains. Play guitar, by the way.
Right, and he's a damn good one. I'm Alex. I play guitar and sort of sing for Das Damen.
I'm Jim from Das Damen.
And I'm Eric from The Leaving Trains to play bass. And who are you?
I'm the acting liaison between the interviewer and the rock stars.
They're all rock stars. They're drinking free champagne and they think they're rock stars now. You were all talking about the SST label. Is that something? Is that something special to you guys to be on the label?
Very much.
Yes.
So.
Yes.
And what makes it special?
Thanksgiving
dinner. Just magic three little letters.
It's more than a label.
It's a way of life.
It's more than a label. It's a way of life.
It truly is a way of life. Yes.
How did you, especially a New Jersey, New York band, end up getting signed there?
Well, basically,
it was sheer luck.
No, I don't know.
I slept with Sherlock? Kira Roslin. No, actually,
No.
All right, we'll talk about that later, but,
it's Ross.
I gave a tape to Greg Ginn, and, he was way into it, and, he was into the whole Diamond thing.
And the same would hold true to us. That's all we did, was we gave a tape to Greg Ginn, and he liked it.
Greg picks up on the happening stuff.
To the keys. Yeah. With Greg, really.
Basically, yeah.
Leaving Trains changed members a lot. How long have you guys been in?
What do you mean? Exactly. I mean, how long has this lineup been together? Well, the current lineup has been together about a month before we left on tour, so we're about 2 months old. I've been in the band 2 years. James was a founding member, et cetera, et cetera. But this current lineup has been together about 2 months.
Sounds good.
We have Falling James now from The Leaving Trains here. Do you write all the lyrics for the band?
Yeah, I write just about all of them. Just about all of them. Yes, sir.
A lot of the articles that I've read about you say that you're a poet that leads a band. Would you say that's true?
I'm more like a poet who misleads the band constantly. Like this whole little field trip we went on, I said we're just going to go play Bakersfield, and look where we are. This is a fun place, don't get me wrong. Where is this going to be shown? Locally?
Yeah.
Locally, huh?
Do you consider yourself more of
Andrew,
a musician or a writer?
Let's go!
I consider myself, I get a choice between musician and being a writer?
Well, not a choice, but I mean, do you focus on one more than the other? Or?
No. Yes. Yes and no.
If it's no,
I don't.
Why?
See, I don't. No, I'll tell you why both. Because I don't separate the three of them at all. To me, they're all the same thing. And it's like, you know, writing with crayons on this wall in here. It's all a contribution to society's moral character.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes,
what do
you just
think?
Did. Ask me another two.
Okay, I'll ask you one next.
Okay.
What do you think about the fact that we both have the same first name?
What's your name?
James.
That's my name, too. We're both named James.
What do you think about that?
Shows the lack of imagination
in
American
parents
in the late 1950s and early 1960s.
Oh, well, I was born in 1966, actually.
61.
the musician.
How well do you guys know each other? Is this the first or second date you've been around?
This is the first I found out his name, I'll tell you that.
Well, we've been on about three dates, and it's been pretty happening so far. I haven't kissed him yet, but...
I'm their child.
I'm thinking of going all the way, though, in about three more dates, depending on what we do.
I'm holding out, you know.
Before success, selling bigger, selling a lot more albums.
Let's say the name Fashionable.
Yeah, let's say the next Leaving Trains album hit number four on Billboard and you had a single that beat out Girls Just Want to Have Fun. I mean, and how would you respond? Do you know?
Well, it wouldn't be Girls Would Want to Have Fun. It'd be another Phil Collins single. That's what it would be.
Okay.
And we'd have to, like, go against, I don't know, maybe the Pet Shop Boys again. Well, it would be how it would be achieved.
Would
I mean,
you
if
walk
we actually
away from it, it's what he asked.
Walk away from something that I think, hopefully, a band worked really hard at to get, to achieve, to be there. And when you're there and you've created it or you've been there, making it try to happen, and it's an extension of something that is heartfelt and not posing or ingenuine, I think, yeah, no, I wouldn't walk away from it. It's something that I would be hopefully proud of to put out there. Now, if it was some manufactured, some sort of video artificial, drum machine, fake, something that we thought would be commercially successful but not represent the band, then I wouldn't want to have anything to do with it in the first place. But if the public seems to be the public, all those people out there that buy your records and albums, and we cracked in commercial radio stations, which is going to take a lot of work, and we may have to prostitute our style, I wouldn't be into doing that. I mean, to make what commercial radio is. Unfortunately, commercial radio is what's selling it to the masses and MTV. I don't want to be on heavy rotation on MTV unless the video has some political or social redeeming value that says, hey, you know.